Hey guys, so today I'm going to be doing an eyebrow tutorial. I'm going to show you how I get them looking semi-nice, so let's go. Alright, starting by using the Milani Staple Brow Color, I'm going to be outlining my brows. So I brush them out with the spoolie, and then I'm going to be making two slant lines from the front of the brow, then making the tip and connecting the top part of the brow, and you'll see how I achieve this soon. Excuse the jankiness of my eyebrows, guys. I'm just allowing them to grow out so I can have fuller brows. So see, I'm going to make the tip right now by curving out the arc and then connecting the top part of the brow to the bottom part, and that's how I get my tip. So this brow pomade, I don't really like it, but it gets the job done and it's affordable. Hey, you make what you have work, right? I'm just flickering the beginning of the brow to just form here. I'm doing the same thing to the next brow, making two slant lines at the beginning. And then making the tip and connecting the top to the bottom. It would look much better if my eyebrows were done, but I mean, you just make what you have work, as I said before. And don't have the box shape at the front of your brows, just make flickers to imitate hairs. So I'm just gonna go in with the Jasmine Labelle Brow Powder. And I'm going to be setting the cream product that I just laid down before. You'll realize that I'm doing the same thing, just outlining the brows. And at the end, especially, I'm going to be making tapping motions. And this is just setting the cream, as I said, that we had laid down before. So, outlining the tip. And then tapping it in, tap, tap, tap. To create that sharp tip. And I'm gonna do another brow tutorial when they are done. If that's something that you guys want to see, just comment below and let me know. I'm doing the same thing with the other brow, tapping it in, and that will just set the product. Filling in that sparse area, because as you can see, I have little to no brows, and this is just how I attempt to mimic hairs. Flicker at the front, and that's it. Using the spoolie, I'm just going to be combing through the product to disperse it all over evenly. So now we're going to go in with the Maybelline FitMe Concealer. I'm using the color Cafe. And I'm just going to be cleaning up the bottom part of the brow and the top part if needed. Now I did the top part of one of my brows, and you don't have to do both eyebrows if you don't need to. Because that halo effect people have going on is real and it's not flattering, at least to me. So you'll see when I just do one brow and then I really didn't need it on the other brow, so I didn't do it. Give this a thumbs up, guys, if you like it, and subscribe. Doing the same thing with the next brow, cleaning up the bottom, making the arch, and going down to the tip. this literally takes no time, guys. This is down pat, the fastest way to get your eyebrows looking good for the entire day. Now, as I told you before, I'm going to be cleaning up the top part of this brow because I made a mistake. But I won't be doing it on the other brow because it wasn't needed. You just go ahead and tap that out. Have it melting with your skin. And if you want the tip sharper, you can bring that down to the tip. That hair was bugging me, and so that's the reason why I brought it down. Usually I don't. Another quick tip, you can also use your foundation to do the top part of the brow, because the concealer would normally be lighter. Alright, so there you have it. Perfect brows ready to go. Tell me if you like this, guys. And I mean, if you have more time, you can go in with the Chella defining brow gel. That's what I'm using. You can go in with any brow gel you have tinted. I just prefer the clear ones. And I'm just combing the front of the hairs up and combing the rest of the hairs in the opposite way. That's just how I like it. Look at those eyebrows. Charming, huh? Okay, guys, well, there you have it, the brow tutorial. Comment and subscribe.